Hey everyone, welcome to another Unity and Maya tutorial. So we're going to use both programs today. Sorry I haven't been around, been real busy with different things. So what we got going on here is we have an animation for an animated character, and so yeah, he animates. And once you're ready, let's just say like once you're ready to animate, and like afterwards, like you're done and you're happy and birds are singing and are like, okay, now I want to transfer this to Unity. Well, wait, how do I do that? So that's what this is really about. So a couple ways you can do this is if you have a rigged character and you were very organized and you established everything on layers, such as like right here. Good, because that's going to make it a lot easier, okay? If you didn't, let's get the ifs out of the way now. You can always go up to here and you can deselect whatever you need to, from the geometry to the joints to your handles and to the cursor. Okay, that can get kind of tedious when you're jumping back and forth, and then it just, you hope that you got everything selected properly. So I'm going to use this method with the layers. So I'm just going to right click here, okay, and then deselect. And then I'm gonna absolutely make sure I hold down the shift key, click and drag, okay, and release. So I know both are selected, and we are good to go, okay. So what you want to do now is go to File, go to Send to Unity, and Selection, okay. You can always use all, but be very careful what you know what is being selected in general, okay. Just be very careful. I would always do selection. Just know, because you might have something that is sent to Unity and you just didn't know. So I would say 7 times out of 10 it's not going to cause any harm, but you never know. So next, find the location where you want to send your animation to. And what you do is, I got to find the file. So make sure you know where you're saving, because as you can see, I've got a lot going on. So let's see here. Okay, there we go. Alright, and so I know the location. I'm going to organize this later, so I'm just going to throw it into the generic assets folder and just go from there. Once you're done with that, hit the select, okay? And so right now, you want to do is establish a name. I'll just say Boss Golem Slam, like kind of cult slam, you know. And then from there, you want to have animation selected and bake animation, okay? The geometry isn't really important, okay? I know it kind of like thinks, you kind of might think that it might be, but not in this case, no, okay? I don't need to worry necessarily about NURBS. Well, I don't, you know, this I'm not really concerned about right now, okay? And so this is what we're going to do. Note what your timeline is and what it is. Like, if you know a particular sequence that you want to use, this is the part where you can do that. So specify what we need, or what you need. And I think this one was like at 710. The sequence was at 710. And if not, you can go back and resend it again. Okay? So hit export selection, and let's give it a second. It's going to probably throw like a warning or error, you know, and I haven't had any problems with this. Like, really, I haven't. I know I'm kind of a, you know, kind of a greenhorn, kind of a rookie, but still a student. But I haven't, I have yet had any issues. Oh, you know, of course, always test these things out, okay? And then once we bring up Unity, which I believe that once we get into Unity, it should be there. Remember the name, okay? So I don't need to worry about the game. We'll give Unity a second here. Okay, and let's see. Remember where we placed that at, okay? If you got a lot going on, you can always do one thing. Like, remember the name? Always type it in there. And I think ours was Boss Golem Slam. Hey, look, there it is. Okay. Because we were in the assets folder. Okay. So here's our golem. Look at that. See, it's already animated and we can use that. Now here's a little caveat, okay? I'm gonna click here and just disengage this, okay? So notice that this is kind of like grouped together. The one part that, if you have your character already established, like we already know he's like right here, I believe. Yeah, he's right there. You can always drag it into your scene. Kind of like, it's essentially a prefab, right? So if he's already in there and you're like, well, I don't want to have two bosses on there, what do I do? So like, he's already in here, I don't need to place him in there a second time. So I click there, click on boss golem. That was the original rig that I imported into Unity. And let me get a little bit more room here. Sorry, guys. Okay, so here's the thing. Click on your character. Make sure it's an animator, okay? And never mind this right now. Okay, this is like a lot going on. Yeah. There's a lot going on, okay? Now, the reason why I'm kind of stuttering here is my brain's like, hey, what's going on? Okay, this is the original character. This was for something else in the different function. So here's all the animations, okay? Find the animation in there. And we have it as take001. Be very careful of this name, okay? And the reason why is I have no idea. I think you could specify that name in Maya, but if you find out later that, like, you can't find it, you can always change that name in Unity. So note the triangle shape. Now I think you could change it here if you click once. Sometimes it won't let you. If it doesn't let you, don't worry. You can always change it here. Hit edit. So click on the animation file, the triangle. And then what you do is change the name here. Okay, this is important because you can have a ton of take001. Okay, so I'll call it boss golem slam. Okay, and make sure you hit apply. If I hit enter and then hit apply, so make sure you hit enter and then apply. Okay, so nothing really changes pretty much. It's all in the same location, belonging to the same group. And nothing in the data changes anything. If I hold down the Alt key on the keyboard and click and drag, I can get a full camera rotation on this, and then hit play. You know, I could say, hey, like, can I slow this way down? You know, or can I speed it up? You know. Okay. And then, you know, of course, you can always change. I believe you can go to edit. You can do all kinds of things with this. I could specify what frames, okay? I can also loop it. I don't want to loop this. I don't, okay? So hold, well, click here. Click and drag it to your animator, okay? And there it is. From here on out, you can do different things. You can either just let it run and connect it from, if you right click and make transition, and you know, you can make that as default state if you want to. Okay. You can also call this by script, and we'll go into that another time. I think I did on some other video. Or if you really want to get fancy with this, you could set up parameters that are based on a script, and you know, once this thing starts playing and you know, breathing to life itself, that animation won't play until another event happens in your code. Okay. And yeah, I'll go into that another day. So this is how you do it. So I'm hoping this helped. If you have any questions, please send me a comment. I try to get to some of you guys' questions, and I have a second job, or a primary job. I wish this was my primary job, but of course YouTube says you must have 1,000 subscribers, and yeah. One can hope and dream. So, but yeah, like, comment, and subscribe. So I'm hoping this helped you out. If you have any questions, let me know. Sometimes, oh, I almost forgot. I said we would do another thing here. Okay. I thought I forgot, huh? I did, yeah. All right. So non-rigged character. We have a grenade launcher. Okay. This will be for the game too. Now, essentially, it is kind of pseudo-rigged. You know, we do have controls. You know, for like, animating and, loading, unloading. And then other, bigger controls and stuff like that. So blah 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 blah. Yeah. So I, as a whole, can click on this, okay? Same process, I believe. Send to Unity, selection, find your project, and it's pretty much the same affair. The same process in general. Just make sure you know the location. You make sure you select animation and the checkbox, over there in Unity, I've already got this in there, but I'm gonna go through the same process again just to reiterate and just kind of help you out too. Okay. Where is the folder? Folder, where'd you go? We miss you so. Can't seem to find you forever. Ah, there we go. Okay. There we go. All right, there's the location. And if I select there, and then we bring up the next window, I don't got the geometry selected. I have the animation and bake animation. And this one, I'm just gonna leave it here. Okay, and the reason why is I already got that situated. I kind of use the timeline to clip, cut and snip in a way by this process. So you don't need to select the whole timeline. If you only have like an animation that's like 24 frames, you can set if it starts at frame 1 and then frame 24 is where it ends, you can designate that here, okay? And then once you're done, you have your location, you put in a name, make sure this is FBX, okay? That'll help you out so much. I haven't had any issues with anywhere else. And you hit export selection and it throws it to Maya and same process as before. So what I'm saying is you can use this for a rigged character, you can use this as a non-rigged character such as a weapon, which is great. And then you can utilize that. And of course you don't, it's gonna send a whole other model more than likely in this process to Unity, but doesn't mean that you need to go and use the whole, have things show up, and then disappear by code or animation. You can just grab the animation file, drag it up to, let's say for this grenade launcher's animator, just click and drag it, drop it, and then it'll be in there in Unity itself. So it would be in here in the animator, Now keep in mind that make sure you have the right animator. Like, notice how earlier this was a whole other animator. This is another one. The grenade launcher will have another one too, and that's very important. Each one of these have their own animator because, like, we have Boss Golem. Make sure you have its own animation controller, okay? And that's what you can establish here. Have an animator, create a controller, and from there, drop the controller into here, okay? And if you have a question about like how in the world did I create an animation controller? A long time ago, you can easily just find it in the add component section. I think that was like 4 or 5 years ago. What you can do is go to create. Somebody might have seen it already. Animator controller. I think that's the way you would do it. Okay. And then make sure you know where it's at. Okay, please, please know where it's at. Early days of this project, and this is going to be a huge cleanup project that I gotta do later, but I will do it when the time comes. But drop it in a folder with the model and the animation, and you'd be good to go. Okay. So cleanliness, don't do what I do as I say, please. So I hope this helps. ask a question in the comment box if you have any issues. I'll try to get to it as soon as I can. Like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell. I will try to make more videos, but life has been busy. And I even switched schools. So I am now officially a somewhat of a, I guess, a computer scientist. I got my animation, sorry, not my animation degree, my computer programming degree. So that's great. So, but anyways, guys, thank you for everything. I hope you guys have a good one. Good luck on this. If you have any questions, let me know. And from there, have yourself a good one. Bye!